Welcome back to my tutorial, Angular in a month. This is Anil. I am having 5 years of experience in IT field. I am here to help you guys in learning Angular. To help you guys, I have created a Facebook page, Techno UI Expert. In this page, you will get a latest post related to Angular concept. In this post, I have mentioned the YouTube link to my channel and also I mentioned the link to my blog. In the YouTube videos, you will get the practical knowledge about Angular, and in the blog, you will get the theoretical concept. So this is the post that I published just 2 hours before. So in this post, I have shared the YouTube link to Angular interview question and the blog related to those concepts. So today we will cover the remaining Angular interview questions. So today I come to know that in Angular interview, also interviewers are going to ask the concept, the command related to your code, check-in, check-out, means all the commands related to Git. So today in this video, we will cover some of the questions on Angular along with the some of Git commands, so that you have a master on the UI interview questions. So let's start today's session. So in order to start the today's session, I am clicking on the link that I have provided for my blog. So it will redirect to my blog section. This is the blog Angular in a month created by me. So if you see in this blog, I have published a couple of posts. So this is Angular interview question part 1 that I published yesterday. It contains around 16 most probable interview questions. And today I published Angular interview question part 2. It contains some of the questions related to Angular and some of the questions related to Git. Okay, so let's begin. Click on read more. So here is my interview questions. So the first question is, this is the most common question, that is, it is a level 1 question, or we can say round 1 question. So first question is, what is the difference between ng-serve and ng-build command? Okay, please answer. I am pausing the video for some time. Okay, the difference between ng-serve and ng-build. Ng-serve build your application and start a live server to serve your application at port 4200. So what ng-serve is doing, it build your application and start a server to host your application. By default, the port number is 4200. So by doing ng-serve, we are building our application, and also we can able to see our application at the local host 4200. This is all about ng-serve. And if you are doing ng-serve --open, then it build our application and open it in our default browser. Whatever the browser you have default in your system, in that browser your application will start running. Your welcome page will render in that browser if you are doing ng-serve --open. So then come to ng-build. What ng-build is doing? Ng-build build your application that creates a dist folder, dist, or we can say distribution folder, which contain all the files necessary for your project to run. So when we are doing ng-build, then it is creating a dist folder. Dist folder contains all the necessary files that is required for your project to run. Okay, so let's suppose if in your application there is no backend, or we can say there is no service layer or .NET layer for making API calls. Then what you have to do, you simply take the content of the dist folder and upload them to the server. server in which you want to host. Then your application starts running. And now the question is, if you have the backend, like if you have the service layer Java or .NET for API calls, then what you will do? You have to create the WAR file of the Java. Let's suppose you have a Java as the API layer. Then you have to create the WAR file of Java and you have to deploy that WAR file of Java into the same server in which you have deployed the dish folder. So that both are running in the same server and we can able to make API calls. Okay. Then come to the second question. It is also one of the most common question and it's somehow related to the first question also. How to deploy the Angular application to production server? So we have developed an application, Angular application. Now I want to deploy it in my production server. I have the URL of my production server. I have the path of my production server. How to deploy that? First of all, go to your project path, then run ng build hyphen hyphen prod hyphen hyphen base then hyphen href equal to some folder name. What does that mean? First we will come to hyphen hyphen prod means. If we are simply doing ng build, then it also creates a dish folder. But the size of the dish folder is like, it will take the memory, the size of the dish folder is more as compared to the size if we are using ng build hyphen hyphen prod. So adding the production flag like hyphen hyphen prod to ng build reduce significantly the size of your bundle files. Whatever the dish folder that we have generated, if you want to decrease the size, the less the size, it will take the less memory in the server and your applications, like your performance of your application increases. So if you want to decrease the size of the dish folder, then we have to add hyphen hyphen prod to ng build. Okay. So once your dish folder is generated, what you have to do? You take the content of the dish folder and upload them to a server. In the server, the production server that you have. So go to the path of the server, then copy the content of the dish folder and paste it there. If you have a service layer as Java, then also paste the WAR file of Java in that server, in the same folder. So by this, your deployment gets completed. And here there is a note like, if in the server, if you want to deploy in a particular folder, let's we have a production server and there is a folder name called Apple. Let the folder name is Apple. So in that Apple folder, we have to deploy our dish folder content. So for that, since in the server, we have a particular folder in which we have to deploy, for that we have to run ng build hyphen hyphen prod then base href equal to the folder name. Like here we will give Apple, whatever the folder you have in the server in which you want to deploy the your application dish content, then we have to give that folder name here. Or if there is no subfolder in your server, then you don't have to write this base href. Okay. So we can also see it in practical also. Like I already stopped the server. This is my application that I have created, Angular application. If you see in this application, there is no dish folder. Now I want to generate a dish folder. How we can do? Go to the terminal, go to your file path, then you have to do ng build hyphen hyphen prod. Then if you want to deploy that content of this folder in a particular folder available in the server, you have to give a base href, otherwise that is optional. Press enter. So it will take around like 5 to 6 seconds to create this folder. Okay. So मीन होईल देन मीन होईल आई विल डिस्कस वन मोर कॉन्सेप्ट इज इफ यू गो टू योर एंगुलर डॉट जेएसपी हियर इट इज रिटेन इफ यू आर बिल्डिंग योर प्रोजेक्ट इन प्रोडक्शन मोड like this one. So it is replacing the environment.ts file with environment.prod.ts file. Like if you have configured anything in environment.ts file, like the API URL or whatever it might be, you have to write the same code in environment.prod.ts file. Otherwise it will throw an error. Like in environment.ts file, I have added one key Firebase. In my application I am using Firebase as database, so that is different thing. So I want to say, like, in this environment.ts file I have added one more key, that is Firebase. But this Firebase, if it is not present, if we are not writing this one in environment.prod.ts and we are building our project by using ng build hyphen hyphen prod this one, so it will throw an error. It will say the Firebase is not available, because when we are doing ng build hyphen hyphen prod, then as for the configuration angular.json, it is not reading environment.ts file, it is reading environment.prod.ts file. So this is one of the important concept while doing the while building our application. So if you see, like here it is building our application, 40% is completed, we have to wait for 100%. Staying some time. Okay. No worry. So, like, my request is, like, is to all of you, to all the viewers, please go through all the questions in details and please watch the video till the end. And I can guarantee that you will get the knowledge about almost the most possible, most probable and most important question that is being asked by the interviewer in the interview, and you can able to crack any kind of interview that you are going to face in your life related to Angular. This is my guarantee. Okay, still 40% is completed. Okay, it's we'll go to the next question and we'll come back once it is 100% completed. Okay. So this is like ng build, means how to deploy your application. I have summarized this all the steps, so you have to follow that. And the third question is, explain different types of git commands. So this is the question, like, which is being asked by the interviewer in any type of interview, whether it is a Java, whether it is for UI, whether it is for service layer, whether it is for .NET, whether it is for Angular, HTML, whatever it might be, this question is most common. So I think to cover this question also in this tutorial, because I don't want you to fail in any of the interview. I want everyone, each and every one, should get qualified in the interview. Okay, so we'll come to this question. Explain different types of git commands. So first git command, git init repository name. Whatever I have written in the square bracket, like, you have to give an appropriate name for that, and you have to, like, erase this square bracket. You don't have to use this square bracket. Okay, so square bracket means you have to provide a specific value. That's why I am giving it in square bracket. So then first command is git init, then you have to give some repository name. This command is used to initialize a new repository. Okay, then comes to the next command, git clone, then we have to give the URL of the repository that you want to clone. So this command clone the repository from an existing URL. Like in a git we have a code in a particular branch and we want to clone that code so that we will work on that code. So how can we do that? Git clone, then we have to give that URL here. Okay, so it will clone the code available in that repository to your local folder. Then git add file, what it does, like once you have cloned all the files, you will start working on that, and also you have created some new files or new folder. Now once you have your work is done, you want to push that code to the git. How you can do that? As you have created some new files or new folder, we have to use git add then file name. This add the file to the staging area. Means now, still now, the file is not pushed. It is like get ready to push to the repository. So git add is used for all the files that has been newly created, means that is not being present in while git clone. After git clone, whatever the file we have newly created, if you want to push that file to the repository, we have to use git add then file name. Then here it comes git commit. And like you have cloned the repository here, you have started working on that, and if you want to like commit those changes, then you have to use this command git commit minus m, then you have to give a some like some convenient message like service student service changed, routing changed, like any router changed or new routing path added, any convenient message you have to give so that it will help you to track why these files are getting, or means this is able to track why you have made these changes. So you have to use git commit minus m then any convenient message related to that commit. So what it does, it commits or record the file permanently in the WhatsApp history. It commits the files. Okay. Then here you have taken the git clone and you have created some new file by using git add. Now if you want to commit those new file, how you can do that? After git add, we have to use git commit minus m. It commits any file add with git add command. Okay. So like if you want to commit the existing file, then you have to use git commit minus m. If you want to commit the newly added file, you have to use git commit minus m. Okay. Like once, if you want to see what are the files which are not committed, or what is the status of the file, then you have to use git status. It lists out all the files that is to be committed, means that is yet not committed. And then once you have added the file, then you have executed git commit, then you want to next one is you have to push it to the repository. How you can push it? You have to use git push variable name, let it is origin, then branch, you want to push it to the master branch, then you have to give the branch name master here. It sends the branch commit, means whatever we have committed the file here and here, to the remote repository. Okay. Now the process to commit the file is completed. It starts from the git clone, then git add, then git commit minus m, then git commit minus m, then git status to see the files which is to be committed, then last one is the git push. Then by executing up to this, we have pushed the new code to the repository. Now next comes, like it is like recommended to each and every developer to before working on the code, you should take the pull first. So it is advised to all my developer that when you reach the office in the morning, your first work should take the pull of the repository before working on that. So to get the pull, we have to execute this command git pull then the repository URL, from which URL you want to take the full. This URL is same as this git clone. Okay. So what git pool is, there is a difference between git clone and git pool. What git pool is doing, it fetches and merges the changes in remote server to your working directory. So what git pool is doing, whatever the changes that you have pushed in the remote server, it is fetching that changes and it is merging it in your working directory. And what in while doing git clone, we are creating a new working directory. But in git pool, we have the same working directory, but we want to update that directory with the code, like with the newly committed code in the remote server. Okay. So then comes the git checkout branch name. Like now you are in master branch. You want to, like in a repository, there are like more than one branch. In your repository, let's suppose there are two branches, master branch and one is UI branch, or we can say production branch. One is master branch and one is production branch. Now you are working on master branch. You want to switch to the production branch. How can you do that? Git checkout, then production. Here you have to give the branch name. Then we will switch to the production branch. Now we can able to check in, checked out. Then we can clone, pull everything in the production branch. Okay, so to switch from one branch to another, we have to use git checkout. Then comes git merge branch name. So what it will do? So like if like you are working on the master branch, okay, and you want to merge the code from production branch to the master branch, because production is always having the latest and correctly executed code. In production branch, you will get the code without having any error. So now if you want to merge the production code in your master code, means in your in the master branch, means the branch in which you are working, then you have to use git merge and production. It will merge the code in production branch to your master branch. Okay. Then git branch. If you are executing this command, git branch, it lists out all the branches in your repository. Like in repository, you have master branch, production branch, dev branch, and many other branches. Git branch. So there is another command of git branch is git branch branch name. Like now you have master branch, you want to create a production branch. How can you do that? Git branch, then you have to give production. It will create a production branch. Now we can check in and we can commit any code in production branch once it is getting created. If you want to delete that production branch, we have to use git branch like dash d. Dash d means delete, and we have to give the production here. It delete the production branch. Okay. So then comes to the git reset file. Like what here what we are doing is like in git commit we are staging the file. Staging the file means we are making it ready to get pushed. Now because of some reason I don't want to push that committed file. And what we can do, we will use git reset then that file name. Then that committed file will be reset and its contents will be preserved. And if you are doing git reset then commit, if you are doing this one, so what it will do, it will reset all the files that are committed after this commit. Okay. Then comes git difference, git diff. So if you are executing this file, it will show the differences, file differences which are not yet staged, which are not yet committed. We are working in our project. Now we are doing git diff. Then it will show what are the changes we have made on the files. And if we are executing git diff --- stage, what does it mean? It will show the difference between the file in staging area, means the file that is committed, and the latest version of file that is present in the server.
sorry, in the repository. And if you want to compare the code of the two branches, we have to use the DAFF, then like master branch and production branch. I want to compare the code of master and production branch. It's like it will give us the code, like the difference in the code between the master and production branch. If you want to remove any file from your working directory, you have to use git rm file. It will delete the file from the working directory and strict deletion, means it committed deletion. And git log, what does git log is doing? Like if you are doing the, if we are executing this git log, it will list the all the history of the current branch, the number of commits, number of like file pushed, what are the file pushed, like every and every details for that current branch. Okay, and if you are doing git log, git log hyphen hyphen follow, then any file name, let's say I am giving student dot student file. If you are giving git log hyphen hyphen follow, then student file it will be giving. So it will show the history of for that file, means when it is committed, when it is pushed, what are the changes the file have before it is pushed, what is the code written, and after pushed means the code that is being changed, everything get highlighted, everything get listed out for that particular file. Then comes git branch name. That I have already discussed, it creates a new branch, and hyphen d it deletes the specified branch. Then comes the git show, then commit. It shows the metadata and the content changes of a specified commit. Like if you are doing git show then commit, then it will like the file that we have committed, so it will show those changes in that file and some metadata about that file, like the path of that file, the commit message. So here it will show. Then comes git config hyphen hyphen global user dot name, then any name you can give, git dot config hyphen hyphen global user dot email, then email address. So here you can give any name, like I am giving my name Anil. Here you can give your any email address. I am giving anilkar@gmail.com. What it will do? This command will set the author name and email address, which is to be used with your commits. Okay. So if you are committing your code and you want to set your name and email address, you can execute this command. Then each and every commit, your name and email will be registered. Then comes git remote add variable name remote server link. Like you have your own repository, you want to connect that repository to a remote server, so you have to use git remote add, you have to add variable name, you have to give origin, then any server link, means any remote server that you want to connect your repository, you have to give the link here. Okay. This is all about the git commands. There are a couple of commands, so you have to like go through each and every commands. So it is highly essential. So I will prepare one more video and I will demonstrate all these commands in practical. So for theoretical concept, you have to go through all these commands. Okay. So now comes to the terminal. Okay, what happened, man? Still it is 40% period. Oh, somehow it is not started. It is taking a lot of time. It should not take that much of time. Okay, so this build still will leave it for now. Now the build is going to be completed. Okay. So I will remind you again, here I have done ng build hyphen hyphen prod hyphen hyphen base href equal to some folder name in my server. So what it will do, it will create a disk folder for me, and we will take the disk folder and we deploy that disk folder to the server, to the production server in which you want to host our application. Okay. Again, you stuck in 69%. Okay, leave it. It will happen after a couple of moments. Okay. Now comes to the third question. What is the use of package.json in Angular application? This is also one of the most important and level 1 questions, like why we need a package.json in our Angular application. So for the package.json file, it's used to keep track of packages that is being used in an application. In our Angular application, we need a lots of library, lots of packages like @angular packages. So like @angular/core, @angular/forms, like lots of packages we need. So all these packages are mentioned in package.json file. So when we are doing npm install or npm update, then it will reading, it reads the packages that is needed for our application, and it will like download those packages in our node module folder of our application. Okay, if you see here, node module folder, there are lots of packages are available. All these packages have been registered in package.json file. So if we are doing npm install or npm update, then it reading the packages that is needed, that is compulsory for our Angular application, and those packages get installed in or downloaded in node modules file of our Angular application. So package.json is mainly used for tracking the packages that are being used in our application. So in package.json, how the dependency are being, like how we are maintaining, how we are tracking the dependency in package.json. So dependency in package.json is grouped into two categories. One is dependencies and another is dev dependencies. Dependencies are essential to run an application, and dev dependencies are only necessary to develop application. Okay. If you go to our package.json file, here it is. So there is one dependency is there, having a couple of packages that is needed to run our application. This is the package name angular/animation and the version of that package. Similarly, angular/cdk, then version of that package. And these dependencies, whatever the packages mentioned here, are essential to run our Angular application. There are third party packages are also available, like rx.js package, which is third party package, drone.js package, third party packages. So these packages are essential for to run our Angular application. Then one more category is there in package.json one, that is dev dependencies. In this packages, means in this category comes the packages that is needed to develop our application. This is not needed to run our application, this is needed to develop our application, like the CLI version that we have to use to create the component, or like to build our application, like for that we need CLI. What is the version of that? It is mentioned here. And if you want to test our application, then we need the Jaspin version, then Karma version, so then yes, and then the TypeScript version that we need to code our application. Like this is like needed to develop our application. These packages are not needed to run our application. Okay. So now comes to add dependency, we have to use command npm install then dependency name. Like if you want to add Bootstrap to your application, we have to use npm install Bootstrap. It will add the Bootstrap to our package.json file and to the node modules. If you want to add the dev dependency, then same command npm install extra we have to add --- dev, then the dependency name that you want to add. Okay, So these are the three most important questions that is being asked by the interviewer. So I think it helps you guys to crack the interview. Please go through this concept in my blog and please comment on my blog so that I will improve it. And your feedback is highly essential to make it more knowledgeous. Okay. So this is I am ending my sessions here. Thank you guys. Thank you for your time.